Hi everyone, welcome to Wiseshe Makeup, and today I'm going to share with you my technique of highlighting my face, baking my face actually. And I have been baking my face since 2015. The first time that I saw it, I was totally hooked, and since then I have been baking and it really works, especially if you live in a humid city, or if you have oily skin like mine, or if you know, you want your makeup to stay for a very long time, then this is a technique which will really level up your makeup look. So to show you how I bake my face, I have already used the Wiseshe Pro foundation brush to, you know, apply foundation. I like using this brush so that I can use the blender for highlighting and concealing. So this is the Wiseshe precise cut blender, and you can see the size difference. This is like, this gets huge guys, and it doesn't absorb product much, and that is the reason it doubles up in size. So I am using the very famous LA Pro concealer, and I'm going to apply it under my eyes. I'm using the shade Warm Honey because it has a tinge of red into it, so it hides the dark circles and any kind of darkness you have under your eyes. So I'm going to use the inverted triangle method. I hope you can see it. So this way I'm going to just apply it. I've applied a little extra, but that's fine. And I'm going to use this part. Ooh. Blend it. You can use the small blender also, which comes with the this blender, but I'm not going to use this because I'm going to use it for the powder application for the baking. For baking, I prefer using a dry blender. So I'm adding a little bit of a creamy beige shade also into it. I don't do this much often, but just to, you know, so that it is visible on camera. So now let's come to the baking, and you can use any face powder of your choice. I'm using this Edspun, which I got from US. So you can use any loose powder, even Krylon powder is very good. I'm going to take out some here and use this mini blender. It's a very hands-on blender, guys. And just apply under my eye area. So I'm going to bring this to my nose also, so that my nose will appear little smaller in size than what it is. Baking does help in doing that. It brings shades to your face. Contouring and baking. See, my skin is almost drinking the loose powder. It is so... So I'm going to just dip the blender in the powder again and apply it here also. We need to highlight this area as well. And we're going to apply it here. So now the powder has been baked enough, and I'm going to use the Wiseshe powder brush, which is available on Amazon and in our store also. It is the softest brush in our inventory and on Wiseshe, and it's really, really good for removing, you know, excess powder. See how highlighted my face is right now. I hope you can see it. Now I'm going to show you how I'm going to apply the blush. So never, you know, take away the brush like this. Always dab it a bit like this, so that the foundation doesn't, you know, get removed, and the blush also looks nice. Now I'm going to take the NYX matte finish. So hope you like the quick tutorial, and if you want me to do more of these, then let me know in the comment section. I'll see you again. Bye.